Has Christianity always been one of the religions in the world to you?
Oh, hallelujah. Christianity is not a religion. Neither is it a joining of a church and doing the Christian things like praying and giving and so on. Hallelujah. Christianity is the outworking of God's own kind of life received into the spirit of a man. Whoa! This divine life in the heart of a man makes him righteous, keeps him healthy, divinely guided in life, prosperous and victorious. It gives you the ability to enjoy intimate fellowship with the Father and have dominion on this earth. Hallelujah. This is what awaits you if you will wholeheartedly believe that Jesus is the Son of God raised from the dead and personally confess Him as the Lord of your life. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Join Dr. David Binden on the Good Life Devotion every Monday to Friday on this channel and receive truth that will usher you into the Good Life experience.
To understand who Jesus really is, you need to understand certain principles about life, which we'll be sharing with you today.
The new creation in Christ is a present hour reality. It is a now fact. It is not a tomorrow thing.
Jesus said that as the Father has life in Himself, so has He given to the Son to have life in Himself.
We have a lot of religions in the systems, but Christianity is none of them.
This is the NCC Hub with Dr. David Binden.
Wow, praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Such a joy once again to welcome you to today's special episode of your favorite Good Life Devotion. The Good Life Devotion is a daily devotional teaching of the truth of God's Word, aimed at bringing God's sons and daughters all around the world into a state of maturity where we can manifest our divinity to make our world a better place. We also receive truth that help us become effective in the work of the kingdom to bring many more humans into this glorious plan of God for their lives. For some time now, we have been on what we call the NCC Hub, discussing excerpts of previous New Creation conferences through which we transmit the truth of God's Word to cause those who have never been there to receive the ministry of the Spirit, and for those of us who have been there before to be refreshed and also receive the life and spirit of the Word, which never grows old. So be reminded that you can make people also have a transformed life by watching a Good Life Devotion, by praying into it, recommend it to others, and pay to get it to other media platforms. Don't forget that because it's a daily teaching, and we know people have different life patterns, we are on different platforms at different times of the day. Go to our website and look at which platform we are and at which time, so that you can select a platform and follow consistently to receive the truth that we bring to you all the time by the Spirit. So we are going to continue again today looking at another excerpt from last year's New Creation Conference. We have been dealing with the subject of prayer from the realm of the Spirit. And wonderful viewer, you ought to know how important this is. And you ought to watch carefully and listen to the discussions carefully so you can step into a place where you can function from the realm of the Spirit. If we don't get to discuss or ensure that you get the messages on your own and watch them. And this is why you cannot miss this year's New Creation Conference slotted for the 10th and the 11th of this month. That's just in about 2 weeks. You must be at the National Theater. Call us if you're out of Accra or out of the nation Ghana and make arrangements for your transportation and your accommodation and all that so that you don't get caught up in last minute or last hour rush. Again, I'm here today by the grace of God with our esteemed Reverend Dr. Abismael Opokwa-Asare and our esteemed Pastor Dr. Gani. You're welcome.
Thank you, sir, for the opportunity.
So we are going to take a watch at our next set, but before the last sharing word of prayer. Eternal and everlasting Father, we bless you forever. We praise you forever for the privilege, the joy we have to know you and to know the things we know and to be enabled to bring them to the world. We give you praise now and forever. In Jesus' name, amen. Wow. So, viewers, let's take a watch at this excerpt from last year's New Creation Conference, and I'll be right back with my panelists to throw some more light on that. Let's watch this. Are you here today? Let me see if I can run up here. Praise the Lord. There's so much to eat. So, the reasons why you must function from the realm of the Spirit, number one, it's your natural order, your normal order. Number two, that is the control room. Number three,
Number three, you were called to demolish the ungodly foundations of civilizations in the world. And you can only do that by operating from the realm of the spirit. Did you hear that? You were called to demolish the foundations, the ungodly foundations of this world's civilizations. And you can only do that by operating from the realm of the spirit. I'm just saying this to whet your appetite to see why you cannot remain an ordinary Christian who cares less about what goes on in the spirit. Just go to church and clap hands and come home. Those days are past. If you live like that, you'll be bred for circumstances. When you can function from the spirit and be in control. Sir, function from the spirit. I function from the spirit. Do you want to function from the spirit? Yes. Are you with me? Yes. You were called. You know, when we talk about call to dismantle the ungodly foundations of civilization, many Christians don't like that kind of thing. Let me tell you first. The branches of civilizations, they have ungodly foundations. I told you just a few moments ago that Satan is the god of this world. All right. The economic system that operates in the world. What kind of economy is such that I am a country? I produce my own money. Then I say there's no money in the country. I have my machines. Let me just cut more money and produce money. The principles of economy does not permit that. But there's a sovereign bank that can authorize such a process. So there's no money in this country. Produce the money. But there is a law that limits you to do that. Who ordained that law? Nobody is there, but there's a principle universally that forbids you to do that. You cause hyperinflation. Do you understand these things? U.S. is one of the number one funders of IMF. U.S. is worth over 20 trillion now. So who is owing who? And the same U.S. is donating things to countries. What's the dynamics here? There are investment portfolios that can give you 50% a month, 20% a month. If they do that in a country, there'll be trouble. Only a few should be able to do those kind of investments. The rest of you should keep money in the bank. That should give you 3%, 2%. That's proper economy. What kind of economy is that? These are ungodly foundations. Until you think about them, you will not know there's something designed, not by men, but by Satan, to keep majority in poverty, majority in a state of suffering. And you know what? They have been polished nicely on the outside with nice school teachers, nice lecturers, nice professors. You will never think there's anything demonic behind it until your eyes are open in the spirit. Nice banks, nice institutions, you never think there's something demonic. Nice political systems, nice medical system. You think everything is just flashy until you go into the world and look at their foundations. And many of these foundations are set against the kingdom of God. Because the kingdom of God says that all of you must prosper. Those foundations say, no, only a few. The kingdom of God says, all of you are free. They say, no, not everybody is not free like that. Are you getting it? They are foundations against the oppression of the kingdom of heaven. And it is your calling to demolish such ungodly foundations and establish the reign of God.
Wow, wow, wow. You know, every one of the excerpts is a wow. And this is another. Pastor Ghana, let me begin from you. It's You know, sometimes when I rewatch these videos, I say, wow. You know, the area we just went into, you know, we began talking about the fact that born again is an adoption to the family of God. And it's a being born into the kingdom of God. Mm. And that the kingdom of God is a real kingdom, but it's a kingdom in the spirit. The fact that it is in the spirit doesn't mean it is vain or it is empty. It's real. In fact, the spirit world was actually created, meaning that it is real. It's there. Then we said that we are born into it, so we must function from there. It's a must for every child of God. It's not only for people who are, we call spiritual people or powerful people of God. Then we started explaining why it was important that every child of God operated from that realm. Then we said, number one, because that's a natural order. Reverend read the scripture that ye are not in the flesh, but in the spirit. If so be that the spirit of God dwell in thee. He read to us, if you live in the spirit, then walk in the spirit. So we are born into the spirit. And so it's natural, just like the fish in the sea, to function in the spirit realm and function from there. We also explained that though we are in this physical world, somebody would think that if we are in the spirit, then we should disappear so that nobody sees us. But we have been resent as ambassadors. That's why we are here. If not, we have no need being here. So we're actually in heaven right now. Then the second reason why we must manifest, we said, because the spirit realm is the control room. That's where things are controlled from. And Satan knows. That's why, even though he works mostly on the earth, he functions from a realm of the spirit. Then we are going to the third part, which are saying that because we were called to demolish the ungodly foundations of the civilizations of this world. I said all this so that I can say something. We are going into an area, and then in the message, we've been mentioning that a lot of our brothers and sisters have a challenge when they hear us go into these dimensions. What do you mean by demolish ungodly foundations? In fact, they will not even listen to the ungodly foundation aspect. Their mind is demolish civilizations. So it's like, your kind of Christianity is hard. Your kind of Christianity is not the humble Jesus of Nazareth kind of thing. But in fact, they have a wrong mentality about that Jesus. They think Jesus was always humble, being trodden under. No. If you're a Pharisee, you know that Jesus was not a humble person. They ripped a lot of walls. Even said Herod, so go and tell that fox. Jesus was tough. You know, and people don't know the difference between being tough in the spirit and being humble. You know, so we're talking about demolishing the ungodly foundations of civilization. It's like, no, your kind of Christianity is not, you know, it doesn't look humble, it doesn't look submissive, you know, it's controversial and all those kind of things. Why is it like that? Why do even some of our brothers and sisters shun away from these kind of dimensions?
Oh, thank you, sir, for the opportunity. So as you just shared, you know, when this area is being talked about, some have the view that this is disruptive, it's chaotic, you must be that peaceful, you know, person. That is who a Christian is, but that's peace in quotes yeah. Here. Like you shared the example of Jesus. Jesus went to the temple and then he made a whip and he lashed the people.
He turned the tables down.
Turned the tables down. Sacked them.
That wasn't a gentle Jesus.
No.
But if you ask, did Jesus sin?
No.
No. So entering temple, lashing people, turning tables down is righteousness.
Yeah.
Do same thing today against something wrong. And you be classified as disobedient, not humble, acting wrongly. You are not of God. Please rule.
And so many usually have this view. It's just because a lot of people have settled on the earth. But being
come one again. Pastor Ghani said the reason why a good number of our brothers and sisters don't want to be exposed, or they don't even want to see this aspect of their living on earth, and they see it as antagonistic and not as good. They have settled on the earth. I want you to explain that to us. What do you mean by they've settled on the earth?
They've settled on the earth. From all that we've shared so far in the days, we've been born into a kingdom.
Mm.
And it's a spiritual kingdom. Mm. It's the kingdom of Jesus Christ. And we are supposed to be operating from there. But people, somewhere, somehow, over the period, have become disconnected and detached from that.
Mm.
And so all that they think there is all they see happening in this world.
Mm.
So when it comes to their health, it is what is in the environment. When it comes to their finances, it is what the bank is saying.
Mm.
It is what the economists are saying. Mm. If it comes to transportation, it's what is the transportation minister says is what goes.
Yeah.
So they are completely detached from their realities in their kingdom, forgetting that everything, as you taught us, that we see in this world, proceeded from the spiritual realm.
So it's so terrible that even righteousness, peace, and all these are now defined from the earthly perspective.
Hmm.
Why will God judge people? Why will people go to hell? It's because of righteousness. Why will Jesus free people in the temple?
Hmm.
So righteous.
Righteousness.
Now, people don't measure righteousness from the biblical or the spiritual meaning. They measure it according to what pleases men.
Hmm.
They've settled for the earth.
Hmm.
If you guys want to take time here, because if you have been following us on the Glad Devotion, and sometimes you follow maybe some of our releases, news items and things, you watch the message and what we teach, it looks as if we are not the very humbling type. But you need to get near us, and you need to know the biblical definition of humility. And we see that because of this, the light of many cannot shine.
Mm.
Someone is working in the office. Corruption is in that office. He thinks that if he speaks, it is pride.
Mm.
So humility is to conform to rottenness.
Mm. Wow.
And he has no problem because he doesn't see it from the realm of the spirit.
Mm.
And this is why we know that, maybe some may not, but I want to teach you because it is the scriptures. Why have people become so, such that when you talk about the toughness of the faith, then it's like, okay, either you're being disruptive or disobedient or not. But guns are because they've settled on the cross. They think all there is what they see. But that's not true. There is more than what we see. And in fact, we are people originating from a country. Like I said, they've forgotten where they come from. So someone would rather compromise righteousness in the name of what he calls peace. Thinking that there's no peace with God. There's no peace when there's no peace with God.
Yeah.
Anyway, Reverend.
Wow. Just to take us a little back, you defined what operating from the realm of the spirit means.
Mm.
And you said that to be living in this physical body, but operating with heavenly principles. Where are the heavenly principles? Yeah, they're scriptures.
Mm.
So for what a lot of Christians, their problem right now is that many people have left the scriptures.
Mm.
They are not living their lives by the scriptures.
Mm.
For a lot of the examples you have shared, anybody who is given to the scriptures will know that this you are sharing is the truth.
Mm.
Some may not maybe come out to say them, but they know that that is the truth.
Mm.
So as long as many Christians have not given due diligence to the scriptures, it's easy for them to settle in this world.
Mm. As long as you don't give due diligence to the scriptures, you will easily settle for these earthly things. This is why the value of the Good Life Devotion comes in. It's a center for biblically authoritative teachings. We teach the word of God every day of the week. And NCC is a barrage.
Mm.
It's a buffet of the scriptures.
Wow.
And you can go to your Bible and cross-check them. People of God, this is the time to go back into your Bible. See, the dark ages affected the Christian faith. And the church is now recovering from the revivals and the Pentecostal movement. It's now recovering. And we need to give attention to the word of God. If not, there is a pattern of life that we think is the life and it's no life at all. Now, let's go on this short break. When we return, we'll take this matter out. We'll be right back after this break.
This November,
there is a promise Papa God made to Jesus, and you have been called to fulfill that promise.
Be expectant.
They may call you proud, but when you learn to operate in the Spirit, you will bring solution and they will enjoy it.
New Creation Conference with Dr. David Binden. Date 10th to 11th November.
So don't be a Christian that you're always afraid of witches and wizards. What kind of Christian is that? These spirits are your meat. So anytime they tell that I see you in the bottle, you are shaking. Where were you when they tied you and put you in the bottle? Where did you sleep? If any man be in Christ, he's a new creature.
Venue, National Theater, Accra, Ghana. Get ready.
Well, yeah, welcome back. You know, so we're talking about the fact that we've been called to demolish the ungodly foundations. And viewers, I always want to take note of that because you can easily classify it wrongly. We're talking about ungodly foundations of civilization. And we're talking about the economic civilization or the economy of the today's civilization. If now the economy has moved from giving economy through barter system and is now in the fiat economy, many don't know that means of exchange has progressed. And this kind of fiat economy, governed by economic laws, a nation is a sovereign nation. Its central bank has the power to order the minting of its currencies. How then can you say a nation is poor?
You know, it's important to know that, like you've rightly said, a lot of these fundamental laws concerning economics, they are actually influenced by the devil. In Second Corinthians,
they were men's philosophies.
Yeah. So Second Corinthians 4:4 it says, "The God of this world." So, the economies are arranged in such a way that as soon as you begin to print currencies, let's say you say you don't have, so you begin to print. Things have been organized in such a way that immediately you begin to have inflation going out of order.
Inflation. So which law is that?
It is just ungodly laws at work.
The point is, no one questions this. No one sits down and says, it's not that a whole country may be looking for money. Nobody asks, so who controls how we mint our money? Nobody asks. It's as if everybody should understand. We don't understand like that. The Bible said that the earth is full of the riches of the earth.
But it's amazing to add that the nations from which these countries who are allegedly poor go to borrow from, they actually owe the most in the world. So how come they are so much debt but yet are able to lend to
so
other nations?
Owe? Now you can say America is owing, this is owing, and yet they are lending.
Yeah.
Who does it owe? There's something people are not asking. You know, when we say the devil is the God of this world, we need to clarify, he didn't create this world. But when Adam fell, he took control in that early stage of the earth and reorganized the systems the way they work. You see, and we have been sent here to reveal the original system. And for the original system to be revealed, the ungodly one must be crushed. And it is our calling. So if sons of God don't know, so somebody is a Christian, he goes into politics, gets swamped up by these things, and his Christianity can't shine. Yeah. But you didn't go into politics to join something that was ungodly. This is where the message comes in. You go into a school, something evil is happening in the school, you were sent there as a light. And as long as these ungodly foundations continue, men continue to suffer unnecessarily. Let's pray. Let's pray for the world. That the light of God's word will shine through the church, and that the church will get awakened to our place. We are the salt indeed. We are the light. If we don't bring this light, men have no hope. they will just be destroying each other. Let's pray for the world. Pray that the church will wake up and bring the light we ought to bring to the rest of the world. Well, let's pray. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus, oh, how lovely you are. Your heartbeat is what is in our heart right now. Your heartbeat for all mankind and the billions that are suffering because they have put themselves under laws and systems that have been ordained by a wicked force. We break that power in the name of Jesus as we call for the rising up of the church in truth to bring light and liberty to the nations. We give you all the praise and all the glory in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, hallelujah. Praise God. So when you come for NCC, you will not only learn in some areas, you also learn how to ensure that ungodly marital foundations, ungodly educational foundations, those things are broken so that many more will not suffer. You are a light. NCC prepares you to be that light, to be that advantage to your world. Someone is watching us. Briefly, the person to receive Jesus.
Wow, I'm sure having listened to the truth of God's word, you should make up your mind to be born again. To be born again is easy. Jesus has done the work already. All you need to do is to believe in your heart that Jesus died and he was resurrected on the third day. If you believe this with all your heart, you go ahead and confess him as Lord. Say this after me, believing with all your heart. I believe that Jesus died and was resurrected on the third day. I boldly confess that Jesus, you are the Lord of my life. If you have done this, you are born again.
Hallelujah. If you have done this, you are born again. Wow. Thank you so much, Pastor Ghani. Thank you, Reverend Miss Mark, for joining me today. This is my time permit. Surely I'm going to come your way again in our weekend editions of Metro TV and return to you on Monday with another session of NCC's Hub as we prepare ourselves towards the New Christian Conference on the 10th and the 11th. Till then, life is good. Enjoy.
Thank you for joining today's episode of your favorite Good Life devotion with Dr. David Bindan. The Good Life devotion is proudly brought to you by friends and partners of the Final Global Movement.
For more information on how to become a partner, call us on 055-792-7744 or log on to our website finalglobalmovement.org. Become a partner today and contribute to the global spread of God's message for the now.
Follow us on our various social media handles and you will be blessed. Don't miss the Good Life devotion on the channels displayed on the screen at the scheduled times. Till we come your way with the next episode of the Good Life Devotion with Dr. David Bender. Life is good. Enjoy.